Hi guys, it's your girl Steph Scoop, and I'm joined by half of Rudimental, guys. How has your weekend been?
Oh man, it's been crazy. We did Stafford yesterday with VFest. The live set was amazing, massive crowd, and today was just unreal. Today was like, they were shutting down the field because there was too many people in the field. It was sunny, yeah. Everyone was getting involved, it was mad.
You guys seem really passionate when you're on stage. Like, you're getting definitely the full Rudimental experience live. What do you lot love about being on stage?
I guess it's we've worked so hard on an album for the last few years, and be able to bring that live, we all play instruments, and just share that moment with the fans is wicked, man. Yeah. It naturally brings so much energy.
It's mad as well, because they're not just session singers and session musicians that we're working with. They're all of our good friends that we've been working with for years. So like the vibe on stage is, there's like a real, like, you know, tight energy that you're playing in a band with your best mates, you know. It's great.
You guys can say that you're officially made in London, but by next week you lot will be made in America. Are you guys kind of losing sleep thinking I'm going to be at JC's festival next week?
Yeah, no, we're so excited about that. When we got booked for it, we was just like, wow, like Jay-Z's actually booked us for his festival. So yeah, we can't wait. We've just come off a 3-week American tour. And the response we got out there was crazy. It blew us away. So to be going back out there next week, we can't wait. It's going to be wicked.
Why do you think that Americans are starting to pay a close attention to all the new talent like yourselves that's coming out at the moment?
I think their pop industry is kind of, it feels like it's very genre specific, and I think in the UK we like to mess around with genres. So maybe. And obviously, I think people like Adele and Amy Winehouse have come out and done huge over there. So I just think there's a lot of exciting things happening in London and the UK right now. And, you know, it's our turn to shine at the moment, I think.
And also, Americans are very into soulful music. Yeah. And I think they get a little sense of that from our album and feel the soul coming out there. So it kind of transfers across to them, which is really cool.
And that's not the only American gig you guys have got. Working with The Game, How has The Game heard about Rudimental?
That was a crazy one. We were in the studio with Ed Sheeran. We were in the studio with Ed Sheeran in LA. Yeah. And he phoned up Ed Sheeran and goes, I really want to work with you. Yeah. And then we played at a track, we were making a beat, and it kind of sounded like a kind of California-style beat. And Ed just texted The Game, and The Game came down and heard it, and we showed each other music and that. And then we made like 6 tracks with him and really got on with him well. And it was a wicked vibe, and we're really excited about it. So yeah, watch this space.
Does it ever get boring having to be on the road so much, like being away from family, friends?
Yeah, I mean, it doesn't get boring, but you definitely miss your family. Like, it's definitely a sacrifice you've got to make. I wouldn't say, I mean, you can never get bored of this life, because we're living our dream.
Yes, it's exciting to be living our dream, but you do miss family and friends and loved ones, so it gets hard at times, but the music keeps us going.
Yeah. Who has the most annoying habit, finally, on the tour bus that you just want to be like, ugh?
A lot of people stay away from my bunk, because it kind of smells.
What's happening?
Well, I just come off stage without my Emily, and it's a bit mad, really, because I don't do many shows or interviews, so it's a bit weird. But
you've kind of been like the nameless producer in that sense, where people know your name but not actually who you are.
No, but that's what I wanted. That's what I want. I want to be like Banksy of music, but my record label are making it difficult for me, so I have to show my face.
Yeah.
But I like it, I'm enjoying it, because when people connect to your music, it's easier to talk about it. I just didn't want to come out and try to be famous. I just wanted people to connect to something, and then now they want to know about me, which is how I didn't want to do it the other way around. I've not ever done no photo shoots till recently, so I wanted to achieve some success before people take me seriously, if that makes sense.
What is the secret to making a good beat?
It's not thinking about it, or not trying. I don't know, you gotta trust something, you gotta trust other things, like you gotta trust your instincts. You can't sit there and say, oh, I'm gonna make a hit. You just gotta like make sure it comes from a real place, that's all.
How's it been being in the whole festival scenario for someone who's been so secluded to such an open space like a festival?
It's been crazy. Like my first show was Capital Ball, Wembley Stadium with 70,000 people. Like, you don't understand. Like, for that to be your first show, like, they're throwing you at the deep end. So I've got used to it because people kind of love the songs, and that makes it my job easier. So,
what is it about you and Emily Sandé that just works?
It just does. Like, she's my musical soulmate, and whenever we've got free time, we're in the studio, and I think it's because we're such close friends. It's easier to make music, and we trust each other. I think that's the trust is the most important thing.
Definitely. So you have a documentary coming out on Radio 1.
I do.
Tell me about this. Three Street Media, if I'm correct.
Yeah, no, it is. But to be honest, it feels like a bit of This Is Your Life, but I feel like it's too early because I'm just getting started. But it's nice for them to recognise my journey because, to be honest, I was a bit shy of my journey because I went on a game show and I dropped out of uni and I didn't, you know, I was delivering pizzas in 2005. Wow. So. But now I see it as inspirational because I'm not shy about it anymore. So.
And finally, what would you say is the soundtrack to Naughty Boy's life?
The soundtrack?
Yeah.
I don't know. Meatloaf. I would do anything for love.
Oh,
yeah.
Why?
But I won't do that. Mm. I don't know. I just love it.
Forget all this other crap. It's about right now. Just so you know.
Love that.
Exclusive.
Thank you.
Would you like an exclusive?
I would like an exclusive.
Rich, tell them what you do in the bathroom on your own after 11 o'clock at night.
Brush my teeth.
What does he do?
Rich likes to wear tights.
Oh,
that's what Rich likes to do. Yeah, I'm not going to lie. But when you're
that's exactly
when
you're at 11 o'clock.
Is this suspenders? My bag. That's an exclusive.
Is it true that you're going on Celebrity Big Brother? Celebrity Big Brother?
I wish. That'd be amazing.
Would you go on?
I would love to, but unfortunately this time around it's not going to happen. So I guess I'm just going to be here.
Comeback tour coming up.
Yeah.
It starts in November, end in December. Can't wait.
Yeah. So what kind of stuff have you got in store for fans?
Cool. We've got a cheese sculpture.
It's in the sculpture of Stonehenge.
Yeah.
And then we've got.
We keep on moving in the centre.
Yeah. And then we bring out Russian sailors.
Yeah.
And sort of like.
And we've got
take the Mickey out of them.
Tell them about the popcorn.
Sean's
just started a popcorn company
just like that. Right? Yeah. There's this little like routine we do with talking popcorn. It's amazing. And then we do some Derren Brown mind tricks.
Derren Brown's there. And he's in the middle of it all.
Have your management signed all of this off, by the way?
Yeah, of course they have. They got control. We got control.
Oh, and we're going to bring some sheep on the stage.
I love that.
Just to
be bad. Sorry, somebody had to do it.
So, guys, finally, what would be your message for fans who are coming to see you?
Straight up, we love that you guys have even embraced us. It's been 10 years, man. And like, even at me tonight, is it 13?
Yeah.
Thank you, Scott. And the guys are singing the tracks back to us. It's been like, and we're grateful to have been in that position where we've made great pop music and the guys remember it and they're singing it back to us. And to be in this situation right now, at B, with the band as it is, we've been through hell. Like, we've been up and down and left and right, and we're here right now. And that's what I'm saying. That's what it's about.
Have you enjoyed your cigarette with Steph Scoop?
Loved it. It's probably like the best interview.